Robert, thank you very much for handing over, and also a very warm virtual welcome from my side. Let me preface a central statement. ZF is no longer developing new systems for conventional, pure conventional driver and technology. There will be no new conventional ZF transmission. This once again underscores our strategy of pushing climate-friendly driveline technologies and acting as a pacesetter for electric mobility. At ZF, we are pursuing the open technology approach that we have already briefly touched on, and we rely on the durability of solutions. Hybrid and purely electric vehicles will continue to exist parallel to each other for many years to come, as both are useful in their respective fields of application. Since the exact distribution is uncertain, we are pursuing both paths intensively and equipping them with attractive solutions. Our PF solution is EV Plus, the latest generation of plug-in hybrids. EV Plus marks the paradigm shift in the PHEV. Plug-in hybrids are becoming electric cars with certain advantages and no longer combustion engines with electric or auxiliary engines. This concept is suitable as a first vehicle for families and commuters. A purely electric range of more than 100 kilometers in all weathers, regardless of whether auxiliary consumers such as heating or air conditioning are switched on, covers most of everyday's journeys, as already heard before. For longer trips at the weekend or holidays, a modern combustion engine drive is available too. In everyday life, most customers can recharge the electric energy they need for the next day from their home socket or wall box ignite. In Germany, for example, 9 out of 10 electric cars are parked in private parking spaces or garages. This relieves also the existing public load points. The charging infrastructure, which by the way is an essential factor for acceptance and market penetration, can further expand it in parallel for PHEVs and pure EVs. We already proved the technical concept last year with the test vehicle. However, this ZF test vehicle is only the beginning of EV Plus. In the current generation of hybrid automatic transmission, for example, the power electronics are still conventionally installed as a separate module and connected to the transmission via appropriate cabling. Our goal for the subsequent transmission generation was a space-saving solution in which these components are firmly integrated into the transmission housing. At the same time, it was our target to leave the installation space for the module unchanged. In the PF variant of our fourth generation of our 8HP automatic transmission, which we expect to launch in the year 2022, we are able to meet both requirements simultaneously. We integrated the complete power electronics into the gearbox housing for this at the first time. We were also able to keep the installation space identical to that of the previous generation despite integrated components, an important argument for integrating into existing vehicle concepts. This is also possible because the power electronics themselves have been reduced in volume and weight by about 50% each. The unchanged installation space of the entire module was also mastered by a clever cooling concept for the power electronics. The power semiconductors, in particular the IGBTs, for a high voltage variant, produce relative large amounts of waste heat. Also an important measure, however, was that the significant reduction of the hydraulic control system used to trigger gear changes in the mechanical part of the transmission. Whereas the hydraulic control system in the current generation of the 8-speed automatic transmission still requires a volume of 3.1 liters, it will now shrink to about 1.8 liters in the next generation. This was made possible preliminarily by the use of so-called direct shift valves. Unlike the electric pressure regulators used up to now, these electric magnetic actuators no longer require additional pistons or bushings. The performance data of the PF version of this next generation of our 8HP automatic transmission also changes significantly in this comparison. With up to 160 kilowatts of purely electrical power, the system can enable very dynamic driving performance without the need to switch on the combustion engine. The maximum torque that can be achieved without switching on the combustion engine is about 450 Newton meters, thus enabling rapid overtaking even in purely electric operation. The peak performance is about 60% higher than that of the current third generation. ZF has the all-over system know-how for highly integrated system. Everything comes from one source. And only with this expertise, a full integration can be achieved in a space-neutral manner. With this next generation of transmission and its combination, reduced total volume of all components, unchanged installation space of the gear unit module, and significant improvements in performance, security, and flexibility, we thus offer the car manufacturers an attractive basis for bridging the EV Plus concept into serious production. But we are not stopping here. Of course, we are moving on for all electrified passenger cars, and ZF naturally also offers a complete family of electric drive. And we consistently think ahead with technical possibilities for optimizing them. In the future, we will see disconnect functionality, two-speed solutions, 800-volt applications, and new semiconductor technologies. And all of this in a much more elegant design compared to today's solutions. I would like to take a closer look at one example, which is a two-speed drive as an example. The electric ZF two-speed drive integrates a newly developed electric motor with a compact transmission and power electronics. Our competencies and our know-how are linked in an ideal way. We achieve increased climbing ability and acceleration, higher maximum speed. Shifting of operation points in areas which with higher efficiency is also one target. The improved efficiency compared to previous e-drives ensures a higher range per battery charge. In the VLTC cycle, this sums up to 5%. This is achieved because the extreme areas of the map can be cut off. In the remaining map of the e-motor, a more consistent design for efficiency can be made. For vehicle manufacturers, the new two-speed drive offers two options to make effective use of the improved efficiency. In addition to increasing the range while maintaining the same battery size, the OEM could opt for a smaller battery. Thanks to the design of the power unit, the space-optimized design is also suitable for compact cars, for example, to gain more space in the interior. But the new two-speed concept also offers advantages for manufacturers who pursue the performance ideal. Until now, vehicle manufacturers have to choose between a high starting torque and a higher final speed for electric drives. We are now solving this conflict of objectives because the new drive system will be compatible for powerful, heavier vehicles, for example, for cars towing a trailer. With our modular approach, we will be able to combine the two-speed transmission with even more powerful electric machines, up to 350 kilowatts, which promises better acceleration values and potentially higher top speeds. This means that the new drive can meet various requirements on the basis of a modular concept. But we are not stopping at the drivetrain. In order to achieve the highest possible efficiency, we have to understand the e-drive as a complete system and optimize the interaction of the individual components holistically. As a system supplier, ZF can start at many different points in order to realize further increases in efficiency in the individual technology areas. For example, as you can see here, through regenerative braking. The brake control systems are part of a highly developed software network that not only controls and improves vehicle safety and movements, but also energy efficiency. As you can see, we are taking electromobility seriously. From components to systems, we offer suitable solutions to further avoid CO2 in the traffic.